What is up, everyone? Azario here, and welcome to my first OBS Studio video. This is my first time using OBS Studio, and I figured it would be a perfect time for me to try this out while I'm introducing you guys to my latest series. And I want to call this the pre-game video, because this is the video that I'm making before the official playthrough of the game that I will be playing, that I will be beginning. And, you know, I've been trying to use OBS Studio for a while, and my laptop just couldn't really handle it. So I, you know, tinkered around with it enough to where I can do this. Even though the playback of the video is going to be kind of pixelated somewhat, it's not going to look as clear as it is on my laptop screen, but it's going to be pretty good still. So the only thing I can really say is that, you know, until I'm able to get the laptop that I need to perform, you know, this is going to have to suffice if I plan on using OBS Studio. So yeah, so this is the first pre-game video. Now, I will not be doing this for every single game that comes out. That's not what this is for. This is a series of videos that I plan on putting out that has somewhat of a historical slash what's the word I'm looking for? Personal feel to me. Because what I am talking about, of course, you guys see it in the video. I'm talking about Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. And, you know, this is the latest. You know, my glasses just hit the mic. This is like the latest in the Versus series. And I've kind of been falling behind when it comes to the Versus series, because I never really was a big Marvel vs. Capcom player. And I guess another reason for me to do this is because I know that, you know, with a game like Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite, you know, this is a Versus series that goes all the way back to what, like 2000, I believe. I think the first of many of these, actually it came out back in 1996, excuse me, with the original X-Men versus Street Fighter title, which is something else I'm gonna get into as far as the X-Men go. Because there's been some controversy surrounding why they didn't bother to put the X-Men in this game, which I'm pretty sure you guys know already if you've been paying attention to like the news articles and things like that. But just for me personally, just going back to what I was originally talking about, I have not been with some games, I invest more time into them than others. And even though I had fun playing, you know, many games in the Versus series, I never really sat down and tried to dedicate myself to becoming good at the game as much as I was just playing them casually. I wasn't really trying to be like a pro, quote unquote, you know. Games like the Tekken series, including Tekken 7, you know, I've invested like a lot of time in those games. Games like Street Fighter, I invested a lot of time in those. So those are games that I'm good at. The Marvel series is more so of a fast-paced environment, to where if you mess up, like, it could cost you the match, because this is a game of speed and teamwork. And, you know, ever since I would say, what, Marvel vs. Capcom 2, they've, you know, in Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite, they kind of went back to the original 2-on-2 system that they had back in X-Men Cross Street Fighter. So this is kind of going back to the original way that they did things somewhat, you know. And then they add the stone feature to it. It's I'm pretty sure it's going to be entertaining. But, you know, for me personally, I never really was really big on versus games, so don't expect me during, you know, that playthrough to be, you know, super good and super godlike. I do intend to invest time to get better in it, because a lot of, you know, if you've been paying attention to my Twitter, my Instagram, my Facebook fan page, I've announced several times I moved to California like 3 years ago, and growing up in Louisiana, there wasn't a big gaming scene out there, meaning that, you know, there was no big tournaments, there were no small tournaments outside of, you know, you and your friends just getting together and doing like a local couch co-op. There wasn't a gaming scene out there like they have out here in California and in many parts of Texas, Arizona, even Canada, and even in New York, you know, even in Florida, you know, as well as other parts of the United States. They don't have anything like that in Louisiana at all. Even in a city as great as New Orleans, you know, they don't even have anything. So it's like you growing up and you enjoying something, but there's no place for you to go to really try to hone those skills and really try to see if you can compete with the best of them, because the competition, you know, on the block was kind of weak. You know, you investing all this time and energy into learning combos and things like that in a game like this, and it's like everybody else is just like, eh, you know what I mean? So ever since I was little, I always wanted to come to a place where they had a lot of competition, a lot of these prize money tournaments and things like that, because I've always been good at fighting games, and I always wanted to get my hand involved. So, you know, I'm trying to get around more so to do that. And, you know, Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite will be no different than that. You know, I'm trying to get my hand in competition to help increase my skills. And the best way to do that is to compete with people at a high level. And cause I can only do so much locally, you know. So that's the plan with this game. Like I said before, I'm not very good at the Versus series. In the past, like, to be honest, now that I think about it, this is going to be the first Marvel vs. Capcom game I played since the PlayStation 2. Like, really think about that. I'm two generations behind in Marvel vs. Capcom games. The first one I played was X-Men Cross Street Fighter. I actually played that in arcade, so I don't really count that one as far as being at home. But as far as the ones that, you know, I've actually played and had time to invest into, I would say, you know, you had X-Men Cross Street Fighter, and then you had Marvel Super Heroes versus Street Fighter. I played that. Then they had Marvel vs. Capcom Clash of Superheroes, which I didn't play. So I actually played Marvel Superheroes versus Street Fighter, which came out back in 97. I played that. And if I'm not mistaken, like, that was on a Sega Dreamcast. Or was that in arcades when I played it? I don't really know. Like, it's been that long, but as far back as I can actually remember, as far as what I know, you know, I've sat down and invested time into, it was Marvel vs. Capcom 2. That was the last Marvel vs. Capcom game that I played and really, really, you know, tried to get good at it. And that was on a PlayStation 2. So I'm terribly behind on that, because I think they came out with, like, Marvel vs. Capcom 3, and then they came out with that Ultimate Edition, which that was a whole bunch of bullshit in itself. Then they remade Marvel vs. Capcom, and they made Marvel vs. Capcom Origins, which is basically just a remake of Marvel vs. Capcom 2. It just had an online feature. That's all they did different. But I didn't play any of those. And the time between Marvel vs. Capcom Origins and Marvel vs. Capcom 3... you know, those games got released, you know what I'm saying? Like, Marvel vs. Capcom 3, that was all done. Marvel vs. Capcom 3 and Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 was all done in 2011. And Marvel vs. Capcom Origins, that was done the following year, 2012. So let's see, we got 2013, 14, 15, 16, 17. That's what, 5 years of games? But counting back to 2000, when Marvel vs. Capcom 2 first came out, let's see, that's, damn, dude, that's damn near 16 years of Marvel vs. Capcom skill that I barely even had, let alone had time to practice on it. So it's really been 16 years since I even touched a Marvel vs. Capcom game. Like, you gotta think about that. Anybody who plays fighting games knows that if you don't practice, matter of fact, that's in like any type of hobby or in any type of big kind of profession or anything of that sort, if you don't practice, eventually, like, you're gonna lose your skill. And considering that I never considered myself to really have like a high level of skill in Marvel vs. Capcom anyway, I'm gonna get my ass whipped a lot in this game. I'm not even gonna pretend like I'm not. So for me, it's gonna be an uphill battle. It's gonna be an interesting uphill battle. But considering that I wanna get good at Marvel vs. Capcom, it's gonna be one of those, I don't know what to say. It's really gonna be one of those things where, you know I'm not good at it, but eventually I will if I dedicate enough time into it. And this whole gemstone thing that they got, you know, the Infinity Stones, you know, that feature, and that adds a different element to the game, which wasn't in a Marvel vs. Capcom game before. And now that I think about it, you know, again, like, they went from it being three characters on a team back down to two from the original X-Men Cross Street Fighter. I wonder if they're trying to count that gemstone as like the third quote-unquote like teammate. I don't know, like, maybe in a sense, I don't know, like, maybe they're trying to have that happen. I don't know what they're trying to do with that. But yeah, like, so getting back to the X-Men thing, you know, there are no X-Men in this game at all, and that's kind of a massive blow considering where the game originated. Like, I mean, this whole Versus series actually started off with X-Men Cross Street Fighter back in 1996. So to think that there's a Versus game with no X-Men in it, it's like it's just missing something. I don't know. Like, it's just one of those things where it's just, it doesn't make any sense, you know. But, you know, that's business. You know, everybody wants to be in control of certain things, and when that happens, other things have to fall and have to suffer. And it's a shame that Marvel vs. Capcom is one of those games that had to take a blow like that, because, again, it's called Marvel vs. Capcom. Really, at its core, it was always still X-Men Cross Street Fighter. Because even with a game like Marvel vs. Capcom 2, as big of a roster as that had, it was still the majority of Marvel was X-Men, and the majority of Capcom was the characters from Street Fighter. And so it was still X-Men Cross Street Fighter plus all these other friends. That's basically what it was, you know. So it's just, it's weird not having X-Men in a Marvel vs. Capcom game. It just doesn't feel right. Now, I know they're going to substitute, you know, some of the characters, to have the moves of the X-Men to kind of like make up for it, because they already announced that Black Panther was going to be like DLC, and you know he's going to play a lot like Sabretooth. I think they already announced it anyway. Like, he plays like Sabretooth plus somebody else. I actually forgot who they said who else he plays like a fusion of, but I know that Black Panther definitely is going to be like that Sabretooth substitute. Like, he's going to fill that void of Sabretooth, and you know there's going to be several other characters that's going to substitute some of the, especially on the Marvel side, that's going to substitute what the X-Men characters had. Like, they're really going to substitute those moves for some of the characters in this game. So I'm not going to be surprised if you, so don't be surprised if you see fucking Black Panther like with a Berserker Claw attack. Oh, that's who it was. They say Black Panther played like a combination of a Sabretooth and X-23. That's who it was. And so, yeah, man. I'm also kind of hoping, because a lot of people, you know, still kind of mad that Chris Redfield is in Marvel vs. Capcom. Not necessarily mad, but they kind of, just from looking at forums and comments and things like that, and just seeing the feedback from Chris Redfield being in Marvel vs. Capcom, more people actually wanted Leon Kennedy. So I actually like tossed it out there that hopefully what happens is that they actually make like an alternate skin, with like different voiceovers, almost kind of like how they did in Injustice 2, with some of the characters, like with Flash, like he has the reverse Flash skin, and it has its own voiceovers and its own personality, things like that. They even had like Mr. Freeze as an alternate skin and costume, slash secret character for Captain Cold, and it was several other characters, and he just announced Raiden. He has an alternate skin, which is actually Black Lightning, you know, which is a character that not too many people know about. Kind of wish they would have put Static Shock in the game, because Static Shock, he's actually been requested a lot. But this is about Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. I don't want to get too deep into that, but yeah, man. So this is gonna be a wild ride for me, because like I said, like I'm really starting fresh here. Like 16 years and barely having any pretty much having little to no interaction with a Marvel vs. Capcom game for that long. Like, dude, like I'm completely like, man. Even with the other Versus series that they don't really talk about, like Capcom versus SNK. I mean, of course, Marvel vs. Capcom was always a little bit different than Capcom versus SNK. The dynamics are different. I don't even know why I'm trying to count that, but I don't know, man. Like, it's just, it's weird. It's weird. So I'm just going to take it little by little. Take it one step at a time. I did like the demo. I did play the demo, but it wasn't enough to get me to practice, you know, like there's no way for you to just sit there and just relearn everything that you lost 16 years ago. So I'm definitely out of touch. I'm definitely out of touch. But, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just take my time with the game, enjoy it for what it is. You know, I don't plan on getting any DLC for anything like that. I don't think I'm going to get that deep into it. But I will say that I, you know, regardless of me not playing this game for like 16 years, I'm still going to enjoy myself. So that's pretty much it. So I'm going to see you guys for Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. As far as this video, again, this is just a pregame video. This is me getting all of the disclaimers and my thoughts out on a game that you know, I plan on playing. Again, I will not be doing this for every new release coming out. Like, this is not for that. This is just me. If I have any type of special connection with the game, then most definitely I will make one of these for it. But other than that, nah. I don't need to be doing these back-to-back for every single game that comes out. So, yeah, man, so that's it. So, thank you guys for watching my first pregame video, and I will be seeing you for Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite whenever I am able to get it, which should be sometime this week. So, peace.